بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our project entitled Implementation of Strategic Intervention to Remediate the Student and Their Studying Skills of Undergraduate Medical Student. In the era of continuous expansion of the competency-based system in medical education, there is an increase in the growing number of medical students with performance deficits. In our model, the ongoing problem occurred in a newly developed private medical school with two parallel systems, 6 and 5 years undergrad medical program. Our mission was to enhance the studying ability of the remaining 18 students from year two, following the old system, 6 year system, and to explore and implement an efficient, applicable, evidence-based remediation intervention for undergraduate medical students with academic difficulties. In our process, we follow a 3-step intervention plan, starting by step one through data collection to address the cause of performance deficit for each student. Step two, we start to apply our remediation activity through major 5 points. The first one is remediation of the student knowledge and skills through small group discussion session and assessing of their studying skills, time management, learning styles, and goal setting through individual meeting and interview with expert facilitator. Again, we organize peer session with high performance learners from the same or other years. Follow up through web-based schedule formative assessment and feedback for the student following each formative assessment, considering behavioral support through faculty behavioral health team, and lastly, regular advisory session for feedback and detection of the student perspective on different remediation activities. Through analysis of the data collection from the student, the need and need assessment for the student preferred remediation methods mainly through helping in designing a studying plan and through a frequent formative exam, while psychological support, contact of the parents, frequent group advisory meeting, and frequent individual advisory meeting was to a much less extent preferred by the student. But the main two issues to be preferred or two main plan or steps to be preferred by the student is in helping them to design a studying plan and frequent formative exam. By the end of our project, 2/3 of the remedial students were successfully passed the mid-year exam. The result of the end of the year summative exam showed that there is about 13 out of 18 of the remediated student pass the exam. 3 of the remaining student of the final summative exam pass the first trial written exam, and the result of the summative practical assessment showed success of about 90% of the remediated student. Interviews perceived that student greatly appreciated the individual attention and detailed feedback they received during the remediation. Enhanced learner positive motivation, which is evidenced by acceptance of suggestion and shortcoming. In conclusion, each student individual problem that may seem to us as a minor may have the potential to be a handicapping point for him. So it is very necessary to record each and every challenge that we meet with our student during remediation plan and how it was resolved. The loss of in-person classes create a loss of collaborative experience that has significant impact on the educational process, especially in the era of the COVID and during the COVID-19 problem. Direct one-to-one contact with each student was markedly appreciated from the student and had a great impact on their progress. Continuous research can further improve remediation practice that can ensure better student support. Availability of practical guidelines for remediation can be very helpful to guide best practice. Things to be avoided and area need further study in order to guide work with both individual struggling learners and establishment of training policy. Thank you.